everyone needs a house. Every family needs a house to stay in. So, it is a dream of every family to have a comfortable house to stay in. And that is depends upon how and what, when, where to purchase. The questions are like that. So, whether it is advisable to stay in the rented house or is it advisable to purchase own house? For that purpose, we have to take some precautions. If you want to purchase your own house, you should have savings of at least 50% of the cost of the house to be purchased. Initially, you should know that what house do you want to have, what should be the area, what should be the facilities available, what is the location, and how it is comfortable to you, and what will be the environmental issues for the proposed house. So, what are the needs of your family for next at least 15 to 20 years? So that will decide the requirement of house, the nature of house, and also the comfort, the ingredients, means what are the facilities to be available in the proposed house, and the location is also important. So we have to decide, do we need a own house or rented house? Then if you want to go for own house, we should have at least 50%. Then we have to decide what are the requirements, what are the facilities or comforts required in the proposed house. Next, what is the location of the house? Whether it should be near to the office, near to the school, near to the market, or near to the education institution, or near to the hospital, or something. It depends upon the patient's requirements. The location may be decided. And also the opinion of the family members also plays important role in selecting the house, because the people, also everyone should feel comfortable to stay in the house. It should not be against the wishes and whims of the family members, because it's a long-term investment and a dream of the family. And next one is, one more thing to be considered is whether the owner of the house is a permanent resident or is going to be an employee who is frequently transferred from one place to other, and the house will be given on rent to others. That also will decide the cost, the facilities, the location of the house. So when the decision is made to own a house, and the requirements of the house and location of the house, then we have to go for the estimation of the proposed cost of the proposed house. So what will be the cost of the house? Then we have to estimate what will be the with the expected facilities, what will be the price to be until used by the owner. So that will decide. Suppose if a house needs with the facilities expected, needs an investment of rupees 60 lakhs, we can say that 60 lakhs he has to make a financial planning, how to mobilize that 60 lakhs, how much money he is having with him, means whether it is he is having 20 lakhs, 15 lakhs, 30 lakhs, or anything, how much you are saving available to purchase the house, and if it is, and how much to go for loan, and if your own investment is less than 50% or less than half the value of the house, it is not advisable to go to the purchase a house. It is better to postpone. Otherwise, the cost of installment will be uncomfortable for financially. Also, the high value of the house, the rent paid should not be, the installment to be paid should not be more than 1.5 times of the rent. It is a general expectation. It is not that there is a standard procedure. It is a comfortness. Better is if a person is paying rent of 20,000, he can go installment up to 30,000, but not more than that. If the loan installment comes more than 1.5 times of the rent, it is better to postpone it Otherwise, if it is possible that they can manage without going for additional loans and with only installments up to 1.5 times of the rent, the proposal for owning a house can be executed. So, own investment should not be less than the 50% of the house value, and another 50% that can be borrowed from the banks, financial institutions, friends or relatives or anything. Outside money should not be more than 50% of the value of the house. One more precaution should be taken by the borrower, by the purchaser of the house. And next comes is how to make the installment payments, how to plan for the installments, and how much long period, how many years the installment has to be paid, how much it is going to affect the monthly income earned by the borrower, by the owner to repay the installments. The installment payment should not affect the comfortness to the house owner. And if the comfortness is affected, there will be misunderstanding, disturbances among the family members. So it is advisable to go for loan only which is comfortable for repayment. And also we have to see, because the house is longer term achievement, longer term plan and longer term commitments, we have to see the expected financial requirements or short term or emergency requirements, or sometimes expected education requirements or emergency needs or health care or some other thing, that also to be prepared before going for purchasing a house. Because if once invested in a house, you cannot take it back, you cannot pull anything from the house except the discontinuation of rent payment, but it will be replaced by the installment payment. So the financial planning should be in such a way that it should not affect, and it should be comfortable, and happily it should be in a position to repay. That is the primary criteria of acquiring the house.